Thank you, Chair. Today I'm not here for a he said, she said discussion and what door was how far open and who threw it shut. No, our citizens and businesses on both sides of the channel are looking at us, are looking at us to be responsible, are looking at us not to play political games, and are looking at us to reach an agreement. Because they know that a no deal is not in anyone's interest. We are in the middle of an economic crisis of which we cannot see the end. The corona crisis hit our businesses hard, not only the European, but the British as well. The British economy has hit its largest recession on record. So why make things worse with a hard Brexit? How could that serve your and our interest, citizens and businesses? How could that be in anyone's interest? It is not. And I want to thank Michel Barnier for his tireless efforts to try and reach an agreement. It is the responsible thing to do. But we also have to remain clear that the EU will not accept a deal at any cost. We want a fair deal. But what's fair? That's the million-dollar question. Let me tell you what is not fair. A country that wants to leave the European Union but still wants to enjoy the same rights as a member state. It was the UK that decided to leave the EU. It was the UK that decided to be a third country. And now it's the UK government demanding an entire economic bloc of 27 countries to change its way of doing businesses. So when we talk about fair, the UK government cannot expect us to sacrifice our businesses and our fishermen in order to get Brexit done. This is not their choice and they cannot become collateral damage in this story. So what seems fair to me is that the UK can only get access to our market of 450 consumers if fair competition for our companies is guaranteed and our fishermen can continue to fish in British waters. Time is ticking, so let's get Brexit done, but let's get it done right, because a hard Brexit is not in anyone's interest. Thank you.